Here's this ID. You can take that back. Thank you so much. We need your phone number. And how about your email address? First and last. Just being a little bit slow opening the next page. There we go. I need your current residential address. Go ahead and start with the house and street number. And is there a secondary address, like an apartment or a unit? Just a house. What is your zip code there? And okay, perfect. And the city, please confirm. Great. How long have you lived at that current address? Okay. And do you own or rent? Provide me with one reference. This has to be somebody that does not live with you. Okay. And what is their first name? And last. And what is your relationship to them? Go ahead and move on to the employment and income section. This part is just answer to the best of your ability. This will base the majority of the credit limit that you're going to get based on your income as well as your previous credit history. If you have loans, mortgage, student loans, car loans, anything like that, that will all be accumulated into your credit score, which will also be a determining factor of your credit limit or how much money we as the bank are going to give to you to borrow and pay. What is your employer's name? So the name of the company or business. Okay. The address, just the street address and the zip code. Okay. Thank you so much. Okay. What date were you hired there? If you can't remember exactly, just give me the estimate. Okay. And of what year this year? What is your job title at this workplace? And the phone number for your work? How about your boss or supervisor's name, please? What is your monthly gross additional income outside of this job that you make money at. Okay, and what might that be? All right. How much additional income are we talking? All right, so that'll bring a total to System